हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ एस एम माली, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, गोपटे पीयू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेळगावी। वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन यूनिट नंबर 6, दैट इज स्टैटिस्टिकल इन्फरेंस। इन स्टैटिस्टिकल इन्फरेंस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस, देन लार्ज सैंपल टेस्ट एंड स्मॉल सैंपल टेस्ट। In the definitions, we are going to study the definitions like population, random sample, simple random sample, parameter, statistic, sample space, parameter space, sampling distribution of a statistic, then statistical inference, meaning and branches of statistical inference. Also, we are going to study estimation. And in the estimation, we are going to study the definition of estimation, estimator, estimate, point estimation, interval estimation, confidence coefficient, confidence interval, and statistical hypothesis. Again, in statistical hypothesis, null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, and so on. Many definition in detail we are going to study under the statistical inference. Also, we are going to study the large sample test and small sample test in detail. In the large sample test, again 4 different tests we are going to study. That is, test for single mean, test for equality of means of two populations, test for single proportion, test for equality of proportions of two populations. Then, in small sample test, we have to study 2 different tests, that is chi-square test and t-test. So these all tests we are going to study in detail in the statistical inference. Today we will start with some definitions. Here first definition we are going to study, that is population. Last year we already studied this definition. Here the definition of population is the totality of units under consideration is called population. And we have seen that not the human population, but we are going to study, we are going to consider any other population also. Any living or non-living things we are going to consider as a population. Then next definition we are going to study, sample. This also we studied last year. The finite subset of a population is called sample, or a part of a population is called as a sample. The next definition is simple random sample. If the chance of selection of every unit in the population is equal, then it is called simple random sample. Then now we are going to study very important definition, that is parameter. A statistical constant of the population is called a parameter. For example, population mean, that is mu, and population standard deviation, that is sigma, are the parameters. The next definition is statistic. A function of the sample values is called statistic. For example, the sample mean, that is x bar, and sample standard deviation, S, are the statistic. Then the next definition is parameter space. The set of all the admissible values of the parameter is called parameter space, or the set of all possible values of the parameter are called parameter space. The next definition is sample space. The set of all samples of same size that can be drawn from a population is called sample space. The set of all samples of same size that can be drawn from a population is called sample space. The next definition is sampling distribution. The distribution of the values of a statistic for different samples of same size is called its sampling distribution. Next definition is standard error, which is very important. The standard deviation of the sampling distribution is called standard error, and in short it is written as SE. Then we have to study the means and standard errors of some statistics. Here the first statistic is sample mean, which is denoted by small x bar. Its mean is mu and standard error is sigma upon root n. Statistic is x bar, its mean is mu and its standard error is sigma upon root n. The next statistic is difference of means, and difference of means are denoted by x1 bar minus x2 bar, where x1 bar is a mean of first population, x2 bar is mean of second population. So for this the mean is mu1 minus mu2 and standard error is square root of sigma 1 square upon n1 plus sigma 2 square upon n2. This is the standard error. The next statistic is sample proportion, which is denoted by small p, and its mean is p and standard error is root pq by n. Next statistic is difference of proportions, that is p1 minus p2. Its mean is p1 minus p2, where its standard error is square root of p1 q1 upon n1 plus p2 q2 upon n2. The next statistic is difference of proportions only, that is p1 minus p2, where p1 is equal to p2, which is equal to p. Then its mean is 0 because p1 is equal to p2 is equal to p. So p1 minus p2, that is p minus p, is equal to 0, and its standard error is square root of pq into 1 upon n1 plus 1 upon n2. Then we will solve some examples on mean and standard error of a statistic. The first example is given sigma square equal to 9 square centimeter and n equal to 36. Calculate standard error of sample mean. So what is given here? Sigma square is given, that is 9 square centimeter. N is given, that is 36. So we have to find sigma. Sigma is square root of sigma square, and square root of sigma square is sigma, where square root of 9 is 3. So sigma is equal to 3. Standard deviation is equal to 3 here. Therefore we have the formula for standard error of x bar, and standard error of x bar is sigma upon root n. Here sigma is 3, so 3 divided by root n, root of 36. So 3 divided by root of 36, so 3 as it is divided by root of 36 is 6. So 3 by 6 is 0.5. so standard error of x bar is 0.5 for this example. Next question is, sizes of two samples are 50 and 100, population standard deviations are 20 and 10. Compute SE of x1 bar minus x2 bar, that is standard error of difference of means. Now what is given here in the solution? Given n1 is equal to 50, n2 is equal to 100, sigma 1 is equal to 20 and sigma 2 equal to 10. Whatever given values are there, we will write in terms of notations, that is n1 50, n2 100, sigma 1 is 20 and sigma 2 is 10. Then we have the formula for SE of x1 bar minus x2 bar,
is square root of sigma 1 square upon n1 plus sigma 2 square upon n2. Put the values, you will get square root of 20 square upon 50 plus 10 square upon 100. Simplify further, you will get 20 square is 400 divided by 50 as it is. 10 square is 100 divided by 100 as it is. If you simplify further, you will get square root of 8 plus 1, that is square root of 9, and square root of 9 is 3. So this 3 is nothing but standard error of x1 bar minus x2 bar with the given values. Next question, if p is equal to 0.2 and n is 64, then find standard error of p, that is standard error of proportion. What is given here is p is equal to 0.2, n is equal to 64. So we required q, and q is nothing but 1 minus p. So 1 minus 0.02, and 1 minus 0.02 is 0.98. So q is equal to 0.98. Then we have the formula to calculate standard error of proportion, that is SE of p is equal to square root of pq by n. Then put the values, you will get square root of p 0.02, q is 0.98, divided by n is 64. Simplify further, you will get 0.0196 divided by 64. If you simplify further, then you will get square root of 0.0003625. Take the square root, you will get the answer 0.0175. That is, standard error of proportion is 0.0175 for the given data. Then come to the fourth question. If p is equal to 0.5, n is equal to 100, then find standard error of p. What is given here is p is equal to 0.5 is given, then n is equal to 100. We have to estimate q. So q is 1 minus p, that is 1 minus 0.5, you will get 0.5. So q is equal to 0.5. Then we have the formula to find standard error of p. SE of p is equal to square root of pq by n, which is equal to square root of 0.5 into 0.5 divided by 100. If you simplify further, you will get square root of 0.25 divided by 100, which is equal to square root of 0.0025. Take the square root, so you will get standard error of p is equal to 0.05. Then come to the fifth question. A lot contains two defective items, and from that 40 items are chosen. Another lot contains 1% defective items, and from that lot 60 items are chosen. So find expectation of p1 minus p2, that is mean of p1 minus p2, and SE of p1 minus p2, that is standard error of p1 minus p2. First we will write the given values. Here p1 is given 2%. 2% is nothing but 2 divided by 100, and 2 divided by 100 is 0.02. Then we can find q1. q1 is 1 minus p1. So 1 minus 0.02, you will get 0.98. Similarly, p2 is given, that is 1%, that is 1 divided by 100. 1 divided by 100 is 0.01. Now we have to find q2, and q2 is 1 minus p2. So 1 minus 0.01 is 0.99. Also, n1 is given 40 and n2 is given 60. Then we have the formula to find E of P1 minus P2. E of P1 minus P2 is nothing but mean for the difference of proportion. That is P1 minus P2. P1 is 0.02, P2 is 0.01. Simplify further, you will get E of P1 minus P2 is equal to 0.01. 0.01, mean of difference of proportion is 0.01. Similarly, we have the formula to calculate standard error of P1 minus P2, and the formula is under the square root P1 Q1 upon N1 plus P2 Q2 upon N2. Put the values, you will get under the square root 0.02 into 0.98 upon 40 plus 0.01 into 0.99 upon 60. Simplify this further, you will get square root of, you will get simplification of this first term is 0.00049, and the plus the simplification of this second term, you will get 0.00165. Then add these both the terms, you will get square root of 0.000655. Take the square root, you will get 0.0256, and this is the value for standard error of difference of proportion, that is SE of P1 minus P2. Now you can expect from whatever definitions we studied here, you can expect some definitions from this for 1 marks, and whatever examples we have solved, these examples you can expect in the exam for 2 marks each. Thank you.